Hi, welcome back to GeeklyEDU Biology. In this video, we're going to talk about movement in and out of a cell, or otherwise termed endo and exocytosis. So movement in and out of cells is essential for all life. So cells need to be able to communicate to one another or also remove toxins from the cell. Even for our immune systems, it's very important for cells to be able to eat certain pathogens. And there's two main types of movement in and out of a cell, the first of which is the natural movement of a solute, so anything that dissolves in water, going from high to low concentration. And this is called passive transport because no energy is required from the cell to move those molecules. The other one is when a solute goes against its concentration gradient. So this is going from low to high concentration, and this is called active transport, as energy is required to now move these molecules. And you can kind of think of this as passive transport, where a ball is moving down a hill, so it wants to go down its concentration gradient. So this is no energy required. And then you can see with active transport, pushing that ball back up the hill requires a lot more energy. Now, types of active transport in and out of a cell, we have two main types, which is endocytosis. So endo means going in, and then when you see that cytosis, that refers to a cell. And then we also have exocytosis, so now molecules moving out of the cell. Starting with types of endocytosis, there's three main types. The first of which is called phagocytosis, or often referred to as cellular eating. And this is when the plasma membrane engulfs an entire solid molecule. And once this is engulfed by the cell, it forms a phagocytic vesicle. So we can see this here. So this light gray is inside the cell. So this is our cytoplasm. And then here we have the plasma membrane, or our lipid bilayer. And so this plasma membrane will engulf this large molecule. And then the membrane will actually close in on itself to create the vesicle, which will then move to other parts of the cell. The second of which is called pinocytosis, and this can be referred to as cellular drinking. So compared to phagocytosis, which can be thought of as the cell eating a large molecule, pinocytosis is more as ingesting a bunch of smaller molecules. And so here the plasma membrane again folds inward, but then creates more of a channel that allows for dissolved smaller particles to enter the cell, and this forms a pinocytic vesicle. So here we have our smaller dissolved particles, which will again be kind of sucked into the cell, and then the membrane will close in on itself, now creating a pinocytic vesicle. Finally, we have the third type of endocytosis, which is receptor-mediated endocytosis. Unlike the other two types, which will allow for any molecule to come into the cell, this is targeted. So this is only allowing certain molecules to come into the cell, and these molecules must be recognized by special receptors which are in the plasma membrane. So these are very specific to bind to only certain particles. And then once the particle is bound, this will then signal for the plasma membrane to close in on itself and create a vesicle. And so here we see, here's our receptors, which are specific to bind to these blue particles here. And then once they're bound, they will go into a vesicle, which will move within the cell. Next, we have exocytosis. So remember, this is leaving the cell. And here, a vesicle is first formed within the cell, and then it will move to the outer membrane, where it will then fuse to that plasma membrane. Once it fuses to the membrane, the particles will then be dispersed outside the cell. And this is often done when the cell needs to either dispose of waste or produced a new protein or an enzyme that needs to move somewhere else in the body. It will have to export it. And so this is very commonly done. Here is also a nerve cell. So we have to release the signals to other cells in our brain for any sort of reaction. That's it for today's video. I hope that you found it informative and you learned something. If you want more biology or other science videos, please subscribe here for more.